Hello everyone, good morning. Today we will study about the Gibbs phase rule. So Gibbs phase rule was proposed by Gibbs, and this rule applies to the non-reactive multi-component heterogeneous system at thermodynamic equilibrium. Now, the mathematically this is given as F equal to C minus P plus 2, where F is the degree of freedom, C is the number of component, P is the number of phases that is present at equilibrium, and this is plus 2. Now, degree of freedom basically means the number of independent intensive variables like pressure, temperature. Now, in material science application, we deal with the phase changes of different solid structure at constant pressure. So basically one intensive variables becomes less, so we have to subtract one, and now degree of freedom becomes F equal to C minus P plus 1, that is one less, and this phase rule is called condensed phase rule, that is widely used for the metallurgical equilibrium. Okay, the equilibrium that is in metallurgy. Now, so let's see a simple problem based on this phase rule. The number of degree of freedom of a system consisting of solid sucrose in equilibrium with an aqueous solution of sucrose is. So basically we see that we have solid sucrose. That is C12H22O11, that is the molecular formula of this. Okay, now first we have to find the number of components here. So the number of component in this case are two. One is sucrose and one is the solvent, let's it's water. Okay, so the number of component in this case is what? 2. Now what about the different phases? So this is like that. This is suppose water, and we have taken suppose 10 milliliter of water, and we have taken some 20 gram of sugar. What will happen? All the sugar will not be able to dissolve in that. So suppose we have taken even more, like 40 or 30 grams, so all of the sugar will not get dissolved into it. So some solid sugar will stay here, will remain at the bottom, the solid sugar. So there will be equilibrium between the dissolved sugar and the solid sugar. Now, when we talk about the phases, so phase will be one, phase will be solid sugar, and another phase will be solution of sugar with water. So we see that the number of phases are also 2, and the number of components are also 2 in this case. Now apply the Gibbs phase rule, that is F equal to C minus P plus 2. Degree of freedom will be equal to 2 minus 2 plus 2, and it will give you 2. So the correct option is option C here. Now let's do some more examples here. Now these are the examples of the binary systems, and in each of these we have to find the number of components and number of phases. Okay, so one is water plus powdered glass. So water, that is H2O, is one of the component, and powdered glass is SiO2, is the another component. So total component is 2. Now what about the phases? So water and powdered glass both will make heterogeneous mixture, because powdered glass will not be able to dissolve into water, they will not going to form a solution. That's why it will have two phases. One will be water and other will be SiO2. So in this case we are getting two components as well as two phases. Water and oil, again we see that oil has the very large organic molecule containing lot of carbon atoms that is also hydrophobic in nature, so it will not get dissolved into water, so they will form immiscible solution. So the components are two, that is water and oil, and again there will be two phases. Water and oil will not mix together and will not form miscible solution, so it will be immiscible. So again there will be two phases, one will be of water and another will be of oil. Now water and alcohol, again there is one water phase, component, and one is alcohol component, so overall is two. Now if you see alcohol, like see methanol CH3OH, ethanol C2H5OH, so what happens, this has OH bond, oxygen atom is there in alcohol, and they can form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with the water, and they are soluble in water. So water and alcohol will form miscible solution, so there will only be a single phase, so it is homogeneous miscible solution, that is single phase is there. But in the case of oil, both are immiscible, that's why we have taken two phases, one is of water, one is of oil, these two will be separated, okay, they will not intermix. Now water and salt, now these are the values here. Salt we have taken is 1 gram, and water is 10 gram, so we know that the amount of salt is very less, so it can easily get dissolved, equilibrium will not come, so all thus 1 gram salt will be completely dissolved in water, okay, it will not form saturated solution. So in this case component is again 2, because in one is water and one is salt, and all the salt, the amount of salt is very low, so it will easily get dissolved into water and it will form a homogeneous solution, and again this will be of a single phase, because no solid salt will be left, because the amount of salt is very very less. In the second case, again we have two components, one is water and one is salt, but when you see about the number of phases, water is 10 gram and salt is also 10 gram, so the solubility of salt is not too much in water, that 10 gram will be able to dissolve in 10 gram water. For dissolution of 10 gram of salt, we need much more than 10 gram of water, so we need more amount of water for that. So basically what will happen, some of the salt will get dissolved into water and some solid salt will remain. So solid salt, that is the solid salt that will get undissolved, plus solution of water and salt will be the two phases in this case. So overall, these are the two phases in this case. Thank you.